वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम बैक टू द अनदर सेशन ऑफ अवर सब्जेक्ट दैट इज कंप्यूटर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड आर्किटेक्चर. दिस इज द सेवेंथ ऑनलाइन सेशन बेस्ड ऑन द COA. आई होप यू पीपल रेगुलरली वॉच द वीडियोज एंड प्रिपेयर योर बुक properly. When college starts, at that time I will check it, so be careful. You just need to take the screenshot and you need to write in the notebook so that at the time of examination you can read from the book. And there is no requirement of textbook, as I am giving you sufficient material for our subject, right? Now let us begin with our today's session. In today's session I will teach two concept, or we can say two questions. Number one, explain the concept of De Morgan's theorem, and question number two, find the complement of function. So in this particular session I will teach two most IMP topics, and in the 5 mark De Morgan's theorem is there, right? So listen the video carefully to understand what is the concept of De Morgan's theorem. Now let us start with our today's session with first question. State and explain De Morgan's theorem. When you work with the digital programming language, at that time De Morgan's theorem is used. Generally it is useful for the digital circuit diagram, and it is used to solve various Boolean algebra expression. Let me repeat these two points once again. The De Morgan's theorem mostly used in digital programming language. It is useful for making digital circuit diagram, and it is used to solve various Boolean algebra expression. There are two gates, number one NOR gate and number two NAND gate. NOR gate and NAND gate both are the part of universal gate. So generally De Morgan's theorem is useful when you deal with the NOR gate or NAND gate. It allows you to change your AND gates to OR gates by using inverters. That means using De Morgan's theorem you can change AND gate with OR gate and OR gate with AND gate. And for that you need to use inverters. Inverters means what? It is a NOT gate, right? NOR and NAND. NOR means what? Not OR. And NAND means what? Not AND. So using inverter means using NOT gate you can change OR gate into AND gate and AND gate into OR gate. It is extended to any number of variable. Any number of variable, it means what? It is either 2 or 3 or 4. It depends on the input, how many input you want to apply, you want to give, it can be extended up to that number of variable. Let us refer these 5 points once again. Generally De Morgan's theorem is used for the digital programming. You can draw digital diagram and you can solve Boolean expression using De Morgan's theorem. Generally, it is used for the universal gate like NAND and NOR, and it allows you to change AND gate into OR gate and OR gate into AND gate using inverters. Inverters is nothing but using NOT gate. De Morgan's theorem can be extended to any number of variables. That means if you want to use or create De Morgan's theorem for two input variable, it is possible. If you want to create De Morgan's theorem for three input variable, again it is possible. If you want to create De Morgan's theorem for four input variable, it is possible. So you can extend De Morgan's theorem to any number of variable. Now see, when you want to write De Morgan's theorem, at that time you need to understand this one and you need to keep this point in the mind. What point you need to keep? Separate given brackets and change the operator. That means when you separate the bracket, at that time operator is changed. There are two types of De Morgan's theorem, right? There are two types of De Morgan's theorem. One is for NAND and one is for NOR. So for the De Morgan's theorem, what you need to do, you need to open the bracket and you need to change the operator. Say for example, if AND gate is there, at that time dot is used. If OR gate is there, at that time plus sign is used. Now consider the situation that there is a dot operator in between two variables. So when you open the bracket, at that time instead of dot, what operator you need to write? You need to write the plus operator. Now let us prove the first theorem. Theorem 1. As I have told you that there are two types of De Morgan's theorem. So here is a first theorem, A plus B whole dash. Now see, what is our NOT over here? We need to open the given bracket and we need to change the operator. So let us apply that rule. I am going to open this bracket. So when I open this bracket, I need to give individual dash to individual variable. Similarly, over here, plus means OR gate is used. So when we open the bracket, I need to change the gate, I need to change the sign. So for that, instead of plus, what I need to do? I need to use dot. That means I am going to convert OR gate into the AND gate. It is clear to everyone? Now refer the theory. The complement of this one. This point we have written in the theory form. The complement. Complement means dash. Sum of two Boolean variable. Over here we have two Boolean variable A and B. And in between that there is a plus sign. Plus means sum of two Boolean variable, which is equal to product means multiplication, right? Product of complements of these two variables. Complement means dash. Let us repeat this point once again. Over here, our first theorem is what? A plus B whole bracket and dash is there, right? This is the first theorem, which is equal to A dash dot B dash. So in the theory aspect, we can write that sum of two variables, that is variable A and B, and plus sign is there. So sum of two variable is, the complement of sum of two variable is equal to the product means multiplication. So product of complement of these two variables. So both are equal. We are going to prove this, that if I write A plus B whole dash, which is equal to A dash into the B dash. right? Now, in other words, the complement of two or more variables ordered together is the same as the end of complements of each individual variables. What does it means? That, see, this is a OR gate and this is AND gate. So this is the complement of both variable. So complement of two or more variable, as we referred in this previous slide, over here it can extend to any number of variable. So in this case only two variable is there, but if there is a situation where two or more variables are there, right? So that's why I have written over here that, in other words, the complement of two or more variables ordered together, or together means over here plus sign is used, and plus stands for OR gate. So OR together, which is similar to over here AND gate, but complement of each variable. If we have C variable, at that time dot C dash we have to write over here. So which is same as AND of complement of each variable, right? It is a individual variable which contains complement or dash. Let us read these 2 points once again. The complement of sum of two boolean variables, which is equal to the product of complements of these two variables. These both are similar, and in this particular theorem we are going to prove that a plus b whole dash equals to a dash dot b dash. Now see, in other words, the complement of two or more variables ordered together. Ord means over here we have used plus sign. Plus sign is related with the OR gate. So ordered together, which is same as AND of complement of each individual variable. So you can predict that next theorem is opposite of this theorem. Instead of plus, we have dot, and instead of dot, we have plus. So naturally, that is the second theorem of De Morgan's law, right? Over here we have a graphical symbol. See, this particular gate is represented by NOR gate. So this is the graphical symbol of NOR only. Yes or no? In previous slide we have written that it is useful in dealing with NOR and NAND gate. So over here A plus B whole dash represents what? NAND gate. NAND means not, sorry, NOR gate. NOR means what? Not OR. So over here NOR gate can be represented by bubble. So this is the graphical symbol we have already seen. Now see what happens over here. We need to draw another circuit which represents a dash dot b dash. Dot means AND gate. So I have placed AND gate over here. Now what is my first requirement? My first requirement is a dash dot b dash. So instead of a, I need to convert it into the NOT gate. So for that I have passed NOT gate over here. So a dash will be passed over here and b dash will be passed over here, and this is the AND gate. So a dash dot b dash would be the output in this particular case. I want to repeat this theorem once again because our next theorem is based on the same. So you just need to copy and paste it, right? Let me explain the first point. Over here this is called NOR gate because it contains a plus b whole dash. What is De Morgan's theorem? De Morgan's theorem allows you to change AND gate into the OR gate by using inverters. Over here we have used inverter and we are going to change OR gate into the AND gate, right? So in other words, the complement of two or more variables ordered together means this. It is same as complement of this is a and b, and over here a dash and b dash. So it is a complement of each individual variables. Now see, this is the circuit which represents a plus b whole dash, which is nothing but it is a NOR gate, right? And this figure we have already understand in the different types of logic gates, right? At the time of universal gate only we have completed this one. Now to represent a dash dot b dash, you just need to draw AND gate. You need to pass the value of b, a and b by putting NOT gate in between, and a dash dot b dash will be the output. Now there is a time, this is the Boolean algebraic expression. There is a time to develop truth table. You need to write AB 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. This is the value. Now what is my next requirement? I want to find A plus B. So A plus B is nothing but it is the OR gate output. So for OR gate we have written that if both the input signal are 0, at that time output is 0. In rest of the cases output will be 1. So this is the output of OR gate. This is the output of naturally NOR gate. So NOR gate is nothing but it is the opposite of OR gate. So wherever the 0 is there, we need to replace it with the 1, and when wherever the 1 value is there, we need to replace it with the 0. Is that clear to everyone? So left hand side of expression we have find out. Now what is my next requirement? I need to find out a dash dot b dash. So first of all, a dash I need to find out, b dash I need to find out. So for that, a dash means what? Opposite of a. Over here value of a is 0, 0 and 1, 1. So a dash would be 1, 1, 0, 0. Similarly, from the column of b I need to find out b dash. B dash is nothing but opposite of b. That means instead of 0 1 0 1 I need to write 1 0 1 0. So over here I have find out the value of a dash and the value of b dash. Now what is my next requirement? That is dot. Dot represents AND gate. So in AND gate what will be the output if both the input signal are 1? In first case only both the input signal are 1. At that time you will get value 1. In rest of the cases you will get value 0. Right? Now see, these both columns I have marked with the blue color. You can compare the output of a plus b whole dash, which is equal to a dash dot b dash. Here is the proof. Right, that output of this particular value is similar to the output of a dash dot b dash. So from truth table you can say that the De Morgan's first theorem, which is a plus b whole dash, is equal to a dash dot b dash. Is that clear to everyone? Let us refer the whole slide once again. You might be feeling bored, but this is the most IMP question, so I want to repeat these points once again. De Morgan's theorem is used for the digital programming. It is used to develop and draw digital diagrams, as well as it is used to solve Boolean expression. It is useful when you deal with the NOR or NAND gate. It allows you to change AND gate into OR gate and OR gate into AND gate. But for that you need to use inverters. Inverters is nothing but it is a NOT gate, right? And De Morgan's theorem can be extended to any number of variables. It may be 2, 3 or 4, depends on the input signal. You need to keep in mind, there is one rule: when you open the bracket, at that time you need to change the operator. In the first theorem, when I open bracket, individual variable I have applied complement, and instead of plus, so instead of OR gate, I have changed it into the dot, that means AND gate. These 2 points you need to write as a theory portion. graphical symbol. The first graphical symbol is based on the NOR gate, and with the help of NOT gate, I have passed the value of A and B. So A dash and B dash is passed inside the AND gate, and you will get A dash dot B dash. Here is the truth table which finds the value A plus B whole dash. A plus B whole dash represents NOR gate. So the value of NOR gate is 1000. We need to find A dash and B dash. Based on A dash B dash, I need to use the truth table of AND gate, and based on the truth table of AND gate, I will get the value of A dash into B dash. And you can compare these two columns, that is A plus B whole dash and A dash dot B dash, and you can say that the De Morgan's first theorem is similar. Now the second theorem. Over here you need to write the theory that thus proved that A plus B whole dash is equal to A dash dot B dash. Using that, you can say that NOR gate is equivalent to bubbled AND gate. Over here this is called bubbled AND gate, right? So it is equal to bubbled AND gate. This law permits transformation from sum of product. Over here this is a sum of product, right, to a product of sum. Over here product of sum, it allows you. Over here this is the last point. You can write from the truth table that if both the input signals are low, at that time output will be high. If all the signals are low, then output is high, otherwise output is low. Now what you need to do, you need to copy all the theorem, all these points, and convert it into the next theorem. That is, instead of A plus B, I have written A into B. Instead of A dash dot B dash, I have written A dash plus B dash. Now from this theory, what you need to write, the complement of product of two boolean variable is equal to sum of complement of these two variables. See, the complement of the product of two, over here product means multiplication. So product of two boolean variable, which is equal to sum of two individual, complement of two individual variables. And instead of this line, in other words, the complement of two or more variables are AND together, right? This is the reverse operation. So we need to write ANDed together is same as OR of complement of each of individual variable. Over here complement is applied to individual variables using OR gate. Now see, this is the representation of NAND gate. Instead of, this is totally opposite of theorem 1. Over here this is the representation for NOR gate. Over here it is a representation of NAND gate, right? Now what we need to do, we need to use OR gate over here because plus sign is there. We need to pass NOT gate over here because I have a requirement to pass A dash and B dash. So for that I need to pass A dash B dash over here. Don't write A dash over here and B dash over here. You need to write it over here. Over here the value is A and B, and the final value is A dash plus B dash. Now you need to find the truth table. So A into B means what? AND gate. So what is the output of AND gate? 3 0 and 1. A dot B whole dash, this is the representation of NAND gate. How NAND gate works? Reverse of AND gate. So wherever the value is 0, you need to replace it with 1. Wherever the value is 1, you need to replace it with 0. Now it's time to find out the value of A dash and B b dash. So I have found the value of a dash and b dash, and finally a dash plus b dash. So a dash plus b dash, plus means OR. So with OR gate, what is the output? If both the input signal are low, at that time you will get low output. In rest of the cases, output would be high. So now the column which is there in the blue color, you can compare both the columns, and based on that you can write the given point, thus proved that a dot b dash, which is equal to a dash plus b dash, it shows that NAND gate is equal to bubbled OR gate. It allows you, over there is a sum of product which is equal to product of sum, but over here it allows you to convert product of sum to the sum of product, so POS form to the SOP form. And in this, the last point you need to write, that if both the input signal are high, you will get low output. In rest of the cases, output would be low. If any of input is low, your output is high, otherwise output is low, right? So in this way you can write the points. This is the most IMP question which may ask in the exam, and 5 mark question is there, and at that time you need to write both the theorems. Be careful, you need to write both the theorem, theorem 1, theorem 2. Theorem 1 is a plus b whole dash, which is equal to a dash dot b dash, and theorem 2 is a dot b whole dash equals to a dash plus b dash. So this both are the theorems which you need to prove when De Morgan's theorem is there. Stat means proof, right? See the question. State and explain. Stat means you need to prove. And how we prove? From the truth table only, we proved that a plus b whole dash is equal to a dash into b dash, and a b whole dash equals to a dash plus b dash. Now, next question is, find the complement of a function. 2 mark question may ask based on the content, right? So to find the complement of function, you need to keep these 2 points in mind. Number 1, you need to change AND gate into OR gate and OR gate into AND gate. That is the first rule. And what is second rule? Complement of each individual variable. This we have already done in theorem. Right, over here we have converted multiplication into plus, and when I apply complement, at that time I have applied it to the individual variable. Same thing we need to apply over here when there is a concept of complement of a function. Let me repeat this 2 rule once again. First of all, when you find the complement of function, at that time first point is what? You need to convert OR gate into AND gate and AND gate into OR gate. And what is the second requirement? You need to apply complement. Complement means dash or bar, right? So you need to apply complement of each individual variable. Now see, over here the question may ask in this way: f equals to p into bracket q plus r, right? So this is the boolean function they have given. Now what is our requirement? We need to find the complement of a function. So f dash we need to find out. So you need to write f dash over here equals to, make one bracket, inside bracket write p into q plus r, and make again whole bracket. Now when you open bracket, at that time what happens? First of all, you need to apply it into p dash and q plus r whole dash, and instead of, what is our rule? We need to change AND gate into OR gate and OR gate into AND gate. Over here multiplication sign is there, So instead of multiplication, when you make a complement of function, at that time instead of multiplication, we need to write plus sign over here. In other words, you can say that instead of AND gate, you have converted it into the OR gate. Now what happens? See, P dash we have already find out, so we do not require to change it again. Now what is our next requirement? This bracket we need to open. So to open the bracket, the first rule is what? We need to change the gate. So instead of plus, we need to use OR gate, right? And instead of Q and R, change complement each of individual variables. So I need to apply Q dash R dash over here. Let us understand this Boolean algebra once again. If you want to find the complement of function, at that time two points which you need to keep in the mind. Number one, you need to change AND gate into OR gate and OR gate into AND gate. That is the first rule. What is the second rule? When you open the bracket, at that time you need to apply complement to each individual variable. Complement means what? Dash or bar. Generally we people apply the dash, right? So over here f equals to p into q plus r is given as a function. So when we want to convert it into the complement of function, at that time instead of f we need to write f dash. F dash means what? Complement of function. Now make one bracket and apply whole dash sign over here. Now change all gates AND to OR. Over here we have AND gate, so we need to convert it into the OR. And what is the second step? Complement each variable. So I have passed P dash and Q plus R dash over here. Now see, this is again one bracket. So when we open this bracket, at that time instead of plus sign, we need to use multiplication sign. And rule number two, we need to apply complement of each individual variable. So in this way you can find the complement of function. So when simple function is given, f equals to p into q plus r, answer is what? F dash equals to p dash plus q dash into r dash. So this is the complement of the given function. The next complement is what? X into y plus z whole dash. And we need to find the complement for the given function. So what is our first step? We need to write f dash equals to, let me make one bracket over here, and I need to apply whole dash sign over here. Now see, when you apply individual variable, apply complement to the individual variable, at that time x dash is given, and instead of multiplication we need to use plus sign. But in this particular case we already have y plus z dash, right? So again we need to make one bracket and apply dash. Now see, there is a rule of mathematics that dash into dash. So if two times dash is there, at that time gate remains as it is. There is no requirement to change internal gate. Dash and dash we can remove, right? I want to repeat this step once again. See, I have put underline over here that when there is dash and dash, there are two times dash is there, at that time you can remove that dash, right? And gate remains as it is. So what is the output? X dash plus y plus z. Why? Because y plus z dash is already given in the function. So when we apply the dash again, it will be removed and gate remains as it is. Don't change gate over here. That is the rule of mathematics only. Now see, f equals to a plus b dash c plus d dash, right? So in this, if I want to find complement of function at that time, f dash equals to, first of all we need to make one bracket and whole bracket contains dash. Now what is our requirement? We need to apply it to the individual bracket and a plus b dash, this is the formula, it is already given, and we need to apply it into the dash. And instead of multiplication, I need to change it to the plus sign. So instead of AND gate, we have converted AND gate into the OR gate. And again, C plus D dash, this is the function, it is already given. So now, whole dash. Now what happens? Over here, the value of A is there. So if I want to convert over here, so a dash instead of plus, multiplication is there, b dash dash, two time dash is there, so we need to remove it, and b again, plus sign, instead of c what we need to write, c dash, instead of plus we need to use multiplication, d dash is already there. And again you are giving complement. So D dash dash means the value D itself. So F equals to A plus B dash C plus D dash, that is the Boolean function they have given. And complement of that function is what? F dash equals to A dash into B plus C dash into D. In the second Boolean expression, what we learn, that if there is a dash two times in the formula, at that time no need to change the gate, keep it as it is, right? Over here, when you open the bracket, at that time you have two times dash in B, so instead of B dash you need to write B, and the value of A is converted into A dash, and plus sign is converted into the multiplication sign. Now see, over here, AB plus C dash D dash plus B dash D. So when you find complement of the given function, first of all you need to write in between the bracket and apply the dash sign over here. Now give individual dash to individual expression, right? So AB, I have applied dash sign, then instead of plus I need to convert it into the multiplication, CD dash and whole dash, multiplication, B dash D and whole dash. So instead of plus I have changed it into the multiplication, and individual expression contains complement. Now what is our next requirement? Again we need to open this bracket and give complement to each variable. So multiplication sign is there, so we need to write plus over here. Now A and B is there, when you apply dash it will be applied to individual variables. So if AB whole dash is there, at that time A dash plus B, you can, B dash you can write. See, this we have already proven in De Morgan's theorem. I want to show you that once again, that A dash plus B dash is equal to AB whole dash. See over here, theorem number 2, right? So we have found the complement of AB whole dash, which is equal to A dash plus B dash. Now over here, individual complement is there. See, you can remove dash in only if you have whole dash sign over here. If both the variable contains whole dash, at that time only it will be removed. But over here, individual variable contains dash. So what you need to do, C dash dash means C, instead of multiplication you need to write plus sign, and d dash dash means the value of d itself. I want to repeat this point once again. Don't compare c dash d dash with y plus z whole dash. Both are different. Y plus z whole bracket contains dash. In this case, individual variable contains dash, right? So in this particular expression, you don't need to remove dash sign over here. In this particular situation, y plus z whole contains dash, so you need to remove. And at last, b dash d is there, so instead of b dash d, you need to write bd dash. And in between multiplication, instead of multiplication, you need to write the plus sign. The last slide of our today's session, which is based on the complement of function f equals to ab whole dash and cd plus e dash f. So when you want to find out the complement of the given function, first of all make one bracket and apply whole dash sign, then simplify it using ab dash and dash. So see, this is the same as second one over here. Whole dash is there, so it is removed, and you can write ab directly. Instead of multiplication, you need to write plus sign, cd plus e dash f and dash. So now apply it to the individual one. Instead of plus, you need to write multiplication, cd dash e dash f whole dash. Now when you open the given bracket, at that time instead of multiplication you just need to write plus sign. Instead of c and d, you need to apply it to the individual variable, so c dash d dash is there. Similarly, e dash is already there, so dash and dash means e itself plus f dash. The last boolean function is ab whole dash plus cd whole dash. So what will be the output? A, B, C, D. Why? Because both contains whole dash, so whole dash is removed. And instead of plus sign, you need to use multiplication sign. So A, B, C, D is the answer of given function. So in this way, you can find the individual term and complement of a function. So in this session, we have studied two questions. One is called state and prove the De Morgan's theorem, which contains two theorems which you need to prove based on the Boolean function, based on the circuit diagram, and based on the truth table. And the second question is related with the finding of complement of the given function. I hope the concept is properly cleared. You need to write all the questions in the book, right? So at the time of exam, you can easily refer. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you all.